So far, whenever we have created the roles and assigned it to the users, we have assigned the roles directly to the user master records. In this session, we will see how roles are linked with objects in organizational management. When you assign the roles to organization management objects, such as positions, it simplifies and automates user maintenance when the employee changes position. So in this session, we will see how indirect role assignments can be done and how we compare, we do a comparison on user assignments. The reason you would want to use indirect role assignment is because you want to simplify authorization administration in your company by setting up a link with objects in org management, in HR organization management. Now, indirect role assignment means that you do not use or assign the role to one or more users directly in transaction SU01 or SU10 or PFCG. Now, instead of using these transaction codes, you assign the role to a position or a job, which are elements of organization management. Now, assigning roles to positions or jobs has a couple of advantages. One of them is replacement and change, and the second one is time-dependent planning for reorganization. Now, why would you not want to assign roles directly to the users using SU01, for example? What are the advantages, or rather, what are the disadvantages of using SU01 for role assignment? One of the problems with the direct role assignments is that maintaining direct role assignments to users can be very time-consuming for large implementations. And if a user in the company changes department, or if the user's job responsibility changes, you have to adjust their authorizations accordingly. So there's a lot of maintenance that you need to keep doing whenever a user changes his position or changes his job responsibility. So one of the solutions that you have SAP lets you gives you is to create roles on the basis of organization objects. For example, positions in your company such as sales executive or accountant or secretary and so on. So depending on, you build the security based on the positions and the organizations that have been defined. And then you assign the roles to your organizational plan. So what you do is you'll assign the roles to the position or the job, and the users who are assigned to those positions or jobs, hold those jobs, those users then inherit the authorizations according to their positions in the organizational plan. Replacement and change. If you assign the roles to individual users directly, you have to adjust this assignment each time an employee's responsibility changes. If you base the assignment on positions, you don't have to adjust the user role assignments because the user inherits the role from the roles. The user inherits his access from the roles that are assigned to the position. So you base the assignment on positions, not on the users. Time-dependent planning for organizations. Now, what it means is that SAP organization organizational management enables you to plan and activate the validity and assignment of organizational objects according to the time frame available. So you must schedule the program. There is a program to update the user master records. So you must schedule that program to update user master records to ensure that the profiles can be added or deleted in accordance with the changes to the organizational plan. So what time-dependent planning means is that the assignment of the roles could be time-dependent, meaning you can assign the roles to the users for a specific period of time. And to ensure that the roles are deactivated after that certain period, a program for updating the user master records have to be run, has to be scheduled, so that after the period is over, the role assignments get deactivated, or the profiles or the authorizations coming out of the roles are no longer valid for the user. Now, indirect role assignment can be done to the organizational management objects, such as position, in three different ways. PHCG, I mean, you can do both. Like, you know, using PHCG, you can do direct assignment and you can do indirect assignments. And we'll see how indirect assignment is done. Some of a couple of the people using PPOM or PPOM underscore old, you can do the role assignment directly to a position in an org management setup. Now, we have seen these two methods, assigning the roles directly to the users using PFCG and PPOM underscore old. We have seen how we do that in the position-based security demos. So we'll go through briefly over these two mechanisms again. And the third mechanism is using PO13, where you use a relationship between the role object and the position to assign the roles to the users. Now, in all these three mechanisms, you have to run that program to update the user master record. You know, so whichever method you use, that program has to be executed. We'll see what that program is. Now, that program is used to compare the user master record. So, how is the user comparison done? User comparison done in the PFCG screen, or you can run the program directly, or using the transaction PFUD. We'll see in that demo how it is done. Now, why do you need to do that? Why do you need to do a user comparison? You need to do the user comparison for users to be authorized to execute the transaction codes contained in the menu tree of their roles. So their user master record must contain the profiles for the corresponding users. So when you assign the role to the user, the profiles associated with the role are entered into the user master record, because technically speaking, the authorizations are contained in the profiles. So whenever a role is assigned, the profiles associated with that role should be assigned to the users. Now you can start the user comparison from the role maintenance screen under the user tab. So when you go to the user tab, you will see a button for user compare. So you do the user click, when you click on that user compare button, you'll get that user compare the role user master record box. and you can do a role comparison. Now, you can assign the role to the user for a certain period of time, which is that is what is called as time dependency. So you can specify the dates from date and to date for the validity of the role for the particular user. So when you do the user comparison, after the dates are expired, the validity is expired, when you do the user comparison, the system will automatically remove the profiles and authorizations of the role for that particular user. So when you do the comparison, the role and the generated profiles are entered in the user master record. Now, in order to assign the roles to the positions indirectly, I mean roles to the users indirectly using the positions, you need to be able to see, have the proper view, so that you have the maintenance capability to assign the roles to the components in your organizational plan. And that is by default, you may not see the options to assign the role, assign the roles to the org management objects. So you have to maintain the settings in the transaction PFCG if you are using the PFCG method to assign the roles to positions or jobs. So you need to maintain the settings. You have three options there: simple maintenance, basic maintenance, and complete maintenance. Depending on what options you see, what 3D buttons you select in the settings, in the user tab, you will find the org management button. So in order to have, the org management button appear on the user in the user tab, in the settings, you need to select the complete view option. So once you have that button, the org management button, you can click on it. Then you can select the create assignment button box icon on the toolbar, and you'll get a pop-up box with a list of roles and options for roles, job positions, and users, and organization unit. So to whichever object, the job, position, org unit, whichever object you want to assign the role to, you can double click on it and then assign the role to that particular object. Now, when you create this assignment, if you select the position type, you can assign the users to a role to the position, or if you select the job, you can assign the role to the job. Now, in order to do this, the position should be related to the person, meaning the user to whom you want to assign the role, his position should be associated with his user ID. So and we know that the user ID and the position link is maintained through a partner. So we have to maintain the info type 105, where we link the partner to the user ID. And then the position is related to the user. So for example, here, say for example, the position 5450 is related to the user B and Z. Similarly, 42 is related to Greco, David Greco. So this link has to be made, and every user needs to have a Perner, and that link between the Perner and the user ID is maintained in InfoType 1, in 105. So you can define in the relationship such as positions, jobs, or org units when you choose the create assignment option. Now, if you choose the if you choose to use the indirect user assignment reconciliation, which is the small icon that is trying to be hidden here, that is for user comparison. The system reconciles the positions and the users assigned. Now, the users that were newly added are entered, and the user assignments are no longer current or deleted. That are no longer current are deleted. So, which means once you do the user comparison, if any for a user ID, if there is any role which had a validity period on it, when you do the user comparison, the authorizations from those roles are removed. So during the reconciliation process, the users assigned on the basis of the positions are entered as indirect user assignments for the role. So when you go to the SU01 screen and take a look at the role tab, the indirect role assignments will appear to you in blue color, whereas a direct role assignment would appear to you in a black color. Now, since the assignments in the org management are time dependent, you must take this time dependency into account when you assign the users. Now, this occurs during the reconciliation process when the relationship period is copied from the org management for the indirect user assignments. Now, depending on the status, you will see either a green color or a red color, depending on which you can decide whether it need to update the indirect user assignments or not. So when you see a green color, it means that the users are up to date. And if you see a red color, that means the users are not up to date and the indirectly assigned users are not displayed in full on the tab page. Now, this is the program that we're talking about for user comparison. So to do the user master record comparison, you need to execute the report pfcg underscore time underscore dependency as a backlog job to be scheduled daily. Now, you could, if you want to do it immediately, you can execute the transaction code pfird, which calls this program behind the scenes. Now, you can specify the time limit when you specify, when you assign the roles to the user master records. You can see that here. You have the time limit in SU01 as well as PFCG. So you can specify the time limit for the validity of the role. But you cannot specify a time restriction for authorization profiles and their entries in the user master record. Because user master records are linked with the roles, you cannot specify the time limit for profiles and authorizations, but you can for roles. So indirectly, the time period that you specify for the roles, the time validity period, those are applicable to profiles also, provided you run this program, pfcg underscore time dependency, or you run pfird. Now, you schedule a background job for this program, but when you look at the code for this program or this report, you'll find that this program calls this report within it. So for our practical purposes, we need to be concerned about this program and this program. Because when you execute this program and this transaction, this program automatically gets called. Or when you schedule this program as a background job, this program is called. Now, to ensure that only only the authorization profiles valid for a specific day are included in the user master record, you must perform this user comparison daily. When you start the report rhautpd_new, a complete comparison of the user master record takes place for all the roles. The authorizations in the user master records are updated when you run this program or when you run this transaction code PFID. So when the user comparison is done, the profiles with invalid user assignments are removed from the user master record. And the profiles, when I say profiles, we're talking about authorization profiles. And the authorization profiles for valid users, valid user assignments for the role are entered into the user master record. Now, like I said, you can do this user comparison in two ways. Either you run this program in the background mode, pfcg_time_dependency, as a background job nightly, and preferably nightly. You know, do it during the night where there are no people. Generally, users are not logged on. Because if you do it in the daytime, it's possible that the program may fail. Or you can run the comparison using the transaction PFID. Now, as a security administrator, you should run this transaction PFID regularly for control purposes. So this gives you an opportunity to manually correct any errors that occurred in the background. If there is any problem with this job, when you execute PFID as a practice on a regular basis, it gives you an opportunity to correct those errors that may occur because of this program. Now, when you run this this transaction, the system gives you a choice whether you can specify whether HR org management should be included in the reconciliation or not. So there is an option, reconcile with HR org management. So you can select that for reconciling the roles that are assigned to the positions or jobs. So to summarize, if a position-based security is implemented in your customer place or with your company, you could decide or prefer to assign roles to the positions using one of these methods: PFCG, PPOM, or PO13. Now you can assign the roles directly to the users also using SU01 and SU10, but then, like we said, when the user changes position or changes his job responsibility, maintaining the user's authorizations can become a time-consuming effort, because you will have to remove the old access and assign the new access. So you will need to follow a certain process, the set process of filling up the forms, getting the approvals for the new roles. Whereas if you're doing the role assignments through a position, so whenever the user changes the position, the user loses his old access and inherits the new access automatically. So you don't have to do much maintenance there. So it has its own advantages and disadvantages. And because there is a time dependency on the role assignments for organization management objects. You need to execute the transaction PFUD on a regular basis, or you can schedule this program PFCG underscore time underscore dependency on a nightly basis so that the user master records are updated for all users. And also any roles that are not valid anymore, can the authorizations from those roles can be removed. So this is also, remember that the indirect role assignments can be done in three different ways. And we have covered these two methods in the position-based security sessions.